what is the salah, how to pray the salah, and when should you pray, and why should you pray. Salat al-Ayat, as the name suggests, it is a salat that is wajib after one of the signs appear. In Mishnah, it said there are two types of signs. Some signs it is wajib or the wajib to pray salat al-ayat, and some other signs it is mustahab, not wajib. So, specifically the eclipse, the lunar eclipse, keep the solar eclipse, and the earthquake, and the wajib for these three, definitely salat al-ayat should be prayed. Other signs, heavenly signs or earthly signs, not an earthquake, but the earth opens up and swallows the mountain, and the trembles and crumbles. Or no, there is a heavy storm or a blast or wind. In situations, only if the majority of the people of that region or area get afraid and frightened, then Salat al-Ayat doesn't become wajib. What was that? The stand of Prophet Muhammad is beyond the Muslim. There is a specific procedure for this Salat. It's a Turaka Salat. But it has 5 rukur for every raka'ah. So, every raka'ah will have a surah Fatiha and another surah and a ruku. Stand up again, another Fatiha and a surah, second ruku. And this has to be done 5 times, that completes the first raka'ah and then the 2 sajda. Stand up after the 2 sajda. Again, Fatiha and the surah, ruku. Fatiha and the surah, ruku. 5 times. This is one method of praying. There is a second method of praying whereby the 5 rukus are associated with just one surah of the Fatiha. Not 5 different surahs or 5 different rukus. So we take 1 surah of Fatiha and then we divide a surah into 5 parts. You can divide it any which way, but make it 5 parts. Could be a short surah, could be a long surah. Coincidentally, the recommended surahs to be recited for Salat al-Ayat are 4 surahs. Surah Kahf, chapter 18. Surah Nur, chapter 4. Surah Rum, chapter 13. And Surah Yasin, chapter 36. So for example, if you decide to recite Surah Yasin, you can break it up into 5 parts. Yasin, or Muhammad, Hakim, Til, or Kulla Shaykhna, Sayyidahu, Kitabu, Mumin. This is where you recognize the helpfulness of these intervals, which is purchased for us when you review that part of the sign like the Ayn. The Ayn to show, like our report, that you can stop here. So we could stop at Qulla Jaina Sayyidan of the Imam al-Mumin in Surah Yasin, the first rukur. Then in the second rukur, we continue over the Qulla Ashab al-Qariya till we stop at just before Wa Ayatul Rahmul Awdul Maita. That's the second paragraph. Third rukur, wa ayatullahu awdul mayta, till wa nufiha fissur. Nufiha fissur becomes the fourth, till wa ma'alimnahu shi'ra, and then finally, awalam yara al-insan wa anna khalaqnahu min nutfa. That's the fifth rukur. So 83 verses of Surah Yasin, divided into 5 parts, depending on what those paragraphs are called. Same thing we have for the other long surahs. Or no, a short surah can be selected. like, sort of put home on. Surah Imran said, Imran said, now we are able to follow. Bismillah is not to be counted. Bismillah cannot be counted alone for one rukur. So Bismillah, Imran said, or no, we take a surah which cannot be divided into five because it has less than five verses. Aslam was his time, he says you can take one ayah, break it into two. Provided the ayah is made up of two complete phrases. So for example, Qul Allah. I don't know why these four surahs can be recorded, but there must be some connection with ayat and the surah. So I suppose the ayat in Surah Yasin says that ayat 46, وَكَانَ تَأْتِيهِمْ مِنْ آيَةٍ مِنْ آيَاتِ رَبِّهِمْ إِلَّا كَانُوا عَنْهَا مُعْرِضِينَ. We need to throw ayat to one way out in many different signs. And then, Qarabala Azwaja Kullaha, another sign. Ayatum Al-Mulayl, another sign. Oshansu Tajri, another sign. Wal-Qamar Qaddarnahu, another sign. Wal-Qamar Qaddarnahu, this is the experience. And then, Wa Ayatum Al-Mahamalna. And then conclusion, the problem is, not a sign comes to them to remind them, to alert them that there is a power, there is a designer, there is a governor, there is a provider, there is a protector, there is a planner, and there is a destination and a purpose. These people turn their face away, they ignore, he suggests natural phenomena. The Quran says, no, it's not a natural phenomena. One surah of the Quran eclipse has been mentioned as the sign of Qiyamah. It's what Qiyamah? لا أقسم يوم القيامة ولا أقسم النفس اللوامة أيحسب الإنسان أن لن نجمع عظاما بلى قادرين على أن نسوي بنانا بل يريد الإنسان ليفجر أماما. I swear the Qiyamah will occur. I swear the nafs which has been given that guilty conscience will be put to question. It's put to question here in the dunya and finally back in the akhirah. The signs are very clear, but man wants to escape because he's attached to the dunya. Yes, I will. Ayyala Qiyamah. So he asks, right, so you keep on telling us, yes, there is punishment. Where is this Qiyamah? Now Allah begins to mention the signs. What are the signs of the enemies? إذا طريق البصر وخسف القمر. القمر becomes the moon becomes the eclipse. وجمع الشمس والقمر. The solar system, the sun and the moon, they amalgamate. يقول الإنسان يومئذ أين القمر. At that time, man realizes it's too late now. There's an overwhelming power which we can't escape. Coincidentally, one of the geniuses of the 20th century, Stephen Hawking, the paralyzed, wheelchair-bound physicist, British. He said, you know, mankind has about 1,000 years to survive on the Earth. This was his first prediction. Now, recently, he's come up with a new prediction. Mankind can survive on the Earth only for 100 years. Within 100 years, if you don't escape the Earth, mankind has done enough damage to the Earth to destroy itself. That's one reason they're saying, well, there's only millions of stars, millions of planets, and there's life out there. But one reason we don't see any signs from there is maybe they're self-destructive. That is, man can potentially destroy himself. Maybe intelligent beings can destroy themselves. So he says, man will destroy himself.
But in order to escape, let's go to another planet. Target Mars, right here, colonize, making a base for the further space travel.
Well, the Mars says no, we're in the moon. They will come attacking on the moon and the sun will collapse.
Why the sun are examples?
Anywhere else we go.
When the time comes for the end of the world, the universe will collapse. The eclipse is mentioned as a strong sign for that. The Imam Zayn al-Abidin alayhi salam therefore says, when such signs appear, they should remind us about the signs of Qiyamah. We don't know these signs are there, a sign of Rahmah or a sign of Azab. But just like the people of Yunus alayhi salam, when Yunus left the community, one of the islands guided them, leave the city, go outside, pray to God, plead to God, repent to God, and God will remove the azab, and he did it. No community in the Quran is mentioned, be of Mood, be of Mood, be of Saleh, be of Shu'aib, be of Musa. No community is mentioned that they were protected from azab, except for Yunus. And the reason? Wow. So, Imams of the Arabic tell us that we should also, when such a sign appears, pray to God to be protected. And incidentally, better, better prayer than open sky. In a masjid, there is an open part of the masjid. So in future, we need to have facilities where we can pray under the open sky near the masjid. So my proposal is, first rak'ah, we pray the long surah. Surah Fatiha, and then Surah Qiyamah, because that's where it is mentioned all the Khasaf al-Qamar, the eclipse of the moon. I divide Surah Qiyamah into five parts, five paragraphs. And after each paragraph, I four. Better, but not required, to do Qunut. I would skip the Qunut. I would make only one Qunut at the end of the tenth Rukur, before the tenth. So in the Torah As-Salam, we can have five rukuks before the second rukuk, before the fourth rukuk, before the sixth, eighth, and tenth. I will, for convenience sake, I will do only one rukuk before the tenth. So first raka'ah, I'm not taking a very long surah, I'm not taking a very short surah. Medium-sized surah, which is related to the eclipse. Second raka'ah, shortest surah I can get. The way it was done, the system is proposed, we can break it in five parts, inshallah. Jama'ah, better, salah, but you can even pray for that. Lakin, mustahab, to prolong the salah. Mustahab, when you finish the salah, to continue with dua and zikr. Mustahab, even to pray again the salah. So, people who are able, they can pray another Salat al-Ayat. The Ayat is supposed to start at 8:23 and then continue to 10:20 something, so they have 2 full hours. And better that it should be prayed before the eclipse reaches its maximum, which I think should be 9:30 or so. Any questions or clarifications? In case somebody misses out, qaza is not wajib if they didn't know about it. If they knew about it, if they did not pray, then qaza is wajib after the person comes to mind. And women who are excused because they are in a monthly state where the salah is not required of them, then once they become pure after a few days or a few hours, once the eclipse is over, there's no wajib qaza on them. And in case you could make mistakes, mistakes can be of two types. A mistake in the shak I have, is the first rak'ah or second rak'ah. Any shak of a two rak'ah salah, marker, start all over again. But if the shak in the rukuah, it's the first or second, third, fourth, fifth, no, it doesn't matter. Depends where you get that shak, you can correct that shak. Count as a lower number, continue.
joining the salah, just like jama'ah, any other jama'ah prayers. But the only condition is, the person joining should join before or in the rukur, not after that. And that also the first rukur of the five rukurs of the first rakah, or the first rukur of the five rukurs of the second rakah. Otherwise, you won't get the whole salah. Nothing specific, zikr or dua mentioned, just general dua, just general zikr. So maybe these surahs which I recommend, Surah Rum, Surah Yasin, the person can be sacred.
Yes?